Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. We're talking about quadratic equations today. In this video, I want to talk about how you can use the equation of a line to describe or even give a rough sketch of the graph without doing any calculations, really. So in this first two, we have what I would call the vertex form of the line, and the vertex form is what some people call it. Other people have called it standard form. There's a little bit of debate about that, so I'm going to go with this as the vertex form. So we're going to have x minus h squared plus k. That's what I'm calling the vertex form. And so when I look at this, the a in front tells me whether the graph opens up or down. So in this first one, where I see a positive 3, I know for sure my graph opens up. So that tells me one thing about my graph. The next thing I know is, what is the vertex? The vertex I can see from looking at these two values right here. And the vertex here then is 1, 4. And the last thing I would do if I really wanted to give a rough sketch of this is figure out what the y-intercept would be. Remember, the y-intercept is what we get if we make x 0. What if you made x 0 here? You would just plug a 0 in to where the x was, and then you would solve. And negative 1 squared is 1, times 3 is 3, plus 4 is 7. So that tells me that my y-intercept would be 7. And those three things are enough to let me give a rough sketch of this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's my y-intercept. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's my vertex, and it's opening up, so then I would just say my graph, rough sketch, looks like this. All right, what about the second one? Well, it's negative for an A, so then that's opening down. I can look at my H and K to find my vertex, and when I do that, I want to be careful, because notice that the vertex form has a negative sign or a minus sign here in it. And since it has a minus sign and we have a plus, that means that the vertex x value must have been negative 3. And we take the k value as it is, which is minus at the end. So I have those two pieces of information. And then I can also go back like we did before and figure out what the y-intercept is without doing a lot of work. So I'm interested in, if I replaced the x with 0, and then did that calculation, what would I get? And you can do that on your own or on a calculator, whatever. But 3 squared is 9, but that's minus 9. Minus 2 is negative 11. So the vertex of my equation is, I mean, not the vertex, but the y-intercept is negative 11. So if I want to draw this one, I would do it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is where I'm crossing the y-axis. My vertex, 1, 2, 3, negative 2, is here, and I know it's opening down, so then I would want to draw something that looks like this. A downward-facing graph with a vertex where I know it to be and a y-intercept where I know it to be is a nice rough sketch. As I go on to the last three, I'm not using that vertex form. I'm using what I would call standard form, but standard form is ax squared, plus bx plus c. That's just a quadratic equation, and so I'm looking at this now. Well, I'm going to use a little different information because different things are easier to find, but notice that a is still here, right next to my x squared term. So right here, the negative tells me that this is going to open down. I can easily find my y-intercept in this format, because if x is 0, those two terms drop out, leaving a y-intercept of 5. The vertex is a little harder to find here, and this little formula, negative b over 2a, is what I'm going to be looking at. So I'm going to take our negative b would be negative 4, over 2 times negative 1, which is the a. Negative 4 over negative 2 is positive 2. So my vertex first coordinate is 2, and to find, after you find that, you plug in the x to find the y. So I would go back here and say, well, negative 2 squared plus 4 times 2 plus 5, and that's negative 4 plus 8 plus 5, which is 9. So I have a vertex of 9, 2, 9. And so if I was going to draw that graph, up, that's my y-intercept, and then 2, 9 is my vertex. It opens down, and so I would draw this for my rough sketch. All right, let's look at the second one, or the number 4, but the second one of this type. So we have a positive a, so I know it opens up. I know the y-intercept just by looking at that equation. If x is 0, the x's drop out, and I get 0, 2 for a y-intercept. And finally, I want to find out what the vertex is. And so what I would do is take negative b, which is negative 3, over 2 times a, which is 1. And so I can see that the vertex, first half of that, is going to be negative 3 halves. Then I'm going to go back and plug that in to find out what the y value is. I have negative 3 halves squared plus 3 times negative 3 halves plus 2. And I'm going to change all these into fourths because I can see my first one's going to come out to be 9 fourths. And again, you can do that on your calculator. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9 over 2, but negative 9 over 2 would be negative 18 over 4, and 2 is equal to 8 over 4. So again, you can do that, those fractions off to the side or on your calculator, but 9 minus 18 is negative 9 plus 8, and so that gives me that my y value here is negative 1/4. And so then I could sketch that if I wanted. I have, let's see, we're opening up, so I'll go this way, negative 1/2. Whoops, negative 1/2, 1/4, sorry. So it's just below the line. My y-intercept is 2, and so my rough sketch would look like this. And if somebody was to ask you, what's your line of symmetry? Your line of symmetry goes right through that vertex. And so our line of symmetry here would be x equals negative 3/2, if we were interested in that, which sometimes we are, okay? All right, and the last one, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to look at the A and tell you that it goes up. I'm going to look at the last number here, and I'm going to say that the y-intercept then is 0, 10. And I'm going to find the vertex by taking negative, negative 16 over 2 times A. And that makes 16 over 8, which is 2. And then I'm going to go back and plug in 2 to find out my y value, which is like my f of x. So I have 4, 2 squared, minus 16 times 2 plus 10. And that's 4 times 4 is 16, minus 32 plus 10. Negative 16 plus 10, how did I get negative 4 before? 2 squared is 16. And if you're, I think I know what it is, but at the same time, if you're not sure, then you can use your calculator to do that. So I'm going to do that for, because I did it earlier and got a different answer. Sometimes I'm just like, well, which time was I messed up? So I have 4 times 2 squared minus 16 times 2 plus 10. And I'm right, this time it's negative 6. So I have the vertex of 2, negative 6. All right, then I'm going to go back and draw that. My vertex is at 2, negative 6, which is down here, and it goes up. So let's draw this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. Here's 2, negative 6. My y-intercept, though, is at 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So my rough sketch is a very long and skinny looking parabola like that. All right, that's it. Have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.